Hi everybody. Hi, it's Monday again. It's about 4:15, I think. And so if you are watching live, hi, it's Simone here at Caterpillar Physiotherapy and Wellness. I hope you've had a good day. It's cold outside today, so I hope whatever you're doing, you've got lots of layers on and you're wrapped up nice and warm, or you have been, or you will be when you go outside, because if we're outside and we're cold, then we do this. And we scrunch up like this, and our posture goes really bad, and we also do this. And so layer up, layering is the key. So scarves, vests, thermals, coats, cardigans, everything. And then you can still be nice and tall with your posture and have this nice opening in your chest, and also you won't be cold, so it's a double win. For those of you who, you might know this already, but if you don't, then I'm going to tell you. Next week is our 5th birthday here at the clinic, and Caterpillar has been open for 5 years. So we're all very, very excited, and next week there's lots of fun things going on. So if you receive emails from us, you would have already got your email just to tell you about all the exciting things that we've got going on. If you haven't, then email us and ask us. So as you can tell, I am very excited, and everyone here is. We're doing lots of fun things next week. Today, other than keeping warm, the theme of the clinic this week is all about backs. So I'm just going to do just a really quick warm-up. The Facebook Lives are really hard to know obviously where you are. So you might be at home, you might be at work, I don't know what you're doing, and I hope you could just have a little bit of space and just do a little bit of Pilates with me, and that will hopefully make your day a lot happier and you'll feel a lot better. I always have a band and a foam roller, but if you haven't got any of those things, then just work with what you've got. And if you do this workout later on and you're at home, then obviously you can get everything you need. So clear some space, make sure that you're not going to danger yourself or anybody else around you, and you're not going to get into trouble if you're just going to do this workout now. We're going to start with our feet hip-width apart, and we're going to just grow nice and tall. If you need to close your eyes, then do so. I'm just going to do a deep breath. So we're going to have your hand onto your tummy. You can close your eyes. I want you to breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. So deep breath in, breathing out. Deep breath in. Breathing out through the mouth, pull the shoulders down, keep going, and deep breath in, fill your tummy with air, and breathing out as you push your breath out, pull your shoulders down, and breathing out through the mouth. Good. Okay, keep going, let's do two more. Deep breath in, and breathing out, push that breath out, pull the tummy in, and last one, deep breath in, and breathing out. Good. So hopefully, you've tried to just clear your mind, forget what you were doing, excuse me, or be able to focus on the here and now where we are. So as we're breathing, we're gonna sway forwards into the toes, we're gonna swing our arms up to shoulder height, bring them back down again, and hopefully you're not smacking anything on your desk if you are at work. And you know what, get other people involved. If you are at work, you could all just stop for 10 minutes and just do a little bit of Pilates. And if you're doing things like that, then just let me know, and then I can add it in to these lives, because the more you tell me, the more I'm going to be able to help you. Okay, so we're going to put our hands onto our hips, and we're going to peel our heel off the floor into a foot pedal. So if you've been sitting down all day, your feet might still be feeling a little bit tired. If you've got shoes on that are really uncomfortable, you might want to just fling them off. They might be the fascia under the sole of the foot, might be quite tight, so foot pedals are really good. And if you have been running around on your feet all day, then they're going to be a little bit tired. So swapping, on a rise, lifting up out of the waist as you go. Swapping sides, trying as you come back down, try not to sink into the hip, growing nice and tall. So we've got 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Good. Give the legs a little shake. Now if you've got some space, we're just going to stretch our calves, and I want you to take the leg back, So your toes are facing forwards, your lower back is supported. You're just going to press into the wall or onto the desk and then change legs. And again, sometimes lots of people say to me that they've gone for a run and then they've not stretched afterwards. And that's how your body gets really tight. So what I need you to do is all the time swap legs. Think about, even if you've not done anything, your body feels like it just needs a little bit of a stretch. Try doing a calf stretch every day, because that will really help. Bringing up your foot, so you want your knees together as you grow nice and tall, and bring the leg up, and then swap sides. This is also stretching all the way across the knee, over the knee, and all the way up through the quad. So again, growing nice and tall, lengthen and lift and come back down. So good, we should feel nice and long. Now, if you are, your back is absolutely fine, you've got no back injuries or degenerative disease or anything that's going on with your spine, a roll down is really nice. And again, I am telling you this because I need you to be safe. So if you're going to do a roll down and you've got a bulging disc or any osteoporosis or things, you might want to give this one a miss. So if you're not sure, if in doubt, do not do it. But a nice smooth roll down with soft knees, rolling all the way through the spine, coming all the way up is really nice. And then you're going to take a side bend. So if you can't roll down, you can just have soft knees and side bend. If you can roll down, even if you did half a roll down and then a side bend, it's really, really nice just to get the body moving and reaching out of the waist. Slowly, over you go. Rolling down, leaning over to the side. Good, nice, deep breathing. Pulling in and as you're reaching out, which is good. And let's do one more to the other side. And good. So with my legs, I have a sway back. So I really lock into them. So I try to just do a little soft knee. That means that my lower back is supported. You might find that that helps you. So you don't want to be down too much, but just a nice little soft knee. We're going to cross our arms here, or you can have them here, and we're going to spine twist as you go corner to corner. So you're keeping your hips nice and still. And again, this rotation in the spine should be really nice and nourishing, okay? Your head's going along with you, your body. You're not overturning the head because we want to keep it all in line. And a few more side to side. This should feel quite nice. And so as restricting as it is, so you're not going all the way over to the side, you're keeping your hips nice and still, you should feel that spine nice and mobile, and you should feel a little bit free. Okay, now we're going to come down into, back onto the side, this will help you. So we're going to, now we're going to stay into this bend, we're going to bring our arms forward, we're going to open our arm all the way, so we get a really nice twist, pulling our shoulders down, now you're opening your hips, bring, and you can come up each time, breathe out and up, breathe out and up. Should feel really nice. And out and up. And out and up. Let's do one more each side. And relax. Good. Okay. Squats, as you know, I love them. They're really, really good for the whole of the lower body, but also for the upper body, in the nice position where you're holding, opening the chest and using the whole body. So again, if you've been stationary all day, you've been sat down, this is just really nice just to get the whole body moving. If you haven't been stationary all day, running around, you might just want to do some more squats because they are so good for you. So if you've got a roller and you're at home, you'll stand facing to the side, you're going to squat and lift the roller and coming back up again. If you haven't got a roller, not to worry. If you've got a band, you can lift the band up. If you don't want it to come too high, just so that it's in line or nice and low, depending on how you feel. And if you have got a band and you want to make it a little bit harder, so you can squat and pull and in and up. And squat and out and in and up. The same variations for lots of really simple exercises. And don't forget, while you're at home and there's no one supervising you, you've really got to be safe, okay? So we don't want to overdo it. And you might be super, super advanced for Pilates, which is fine. So you know you can make things a lot harder, but you can also make things nice and simple and still benefit, still get a really good workout. Out and in and up and hinge and down and out and in. And this time we're going to stay there. So resist, we're going to pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and up we come. Good. If you haven't got a band, you can still pulse. You can still have your arms forward. You've got this nice open space. What we don't want to do is rise up here. Yeah. If you're bringing the arms up, pull the shoulders down, so you've still got this openness. That means that the chest is working, okay? But really good. You can pause and then do another set if you want to. One last exercise we're gonna do standing up is lunges. Lunging forward, pushing through the foot, coming back up, forwards and up with the arms. Again, you've got your roller. All body, so the arms are coming up, they're resisting the roller, pull, flat back, and let's go again, tuck and curve, and
and stretch and tuck and curve and stretch. We're going to turn and look round to our ankle, keeping our body nice and still. So twist and have a look. And come back. So again, that's really hard for keeping the body still. If you feel that your hips are moving and you're jiggling from side to side, you're not going to feel that stretch as much. So, okay, let's come back to here. We'll do a quick little plank, and we'll do a kneeling plank so that more or less everyone is okay to do this. If you've been told that you're not allowed to do planks, then obviously I don't want you to, but nice little cheeky lift. You're just going to lift the knees and lower. So you can tuck your toes or you can flatten your feet. Come forwards a little bit. And you're just going to lift and down for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10 and lower. Give your wrist a rest. So your body isn't moving. You're not trying to come up too high. You're just literally trying to lift off the floor. You're drawing your abdominals in. The core is lifting you and your weight's forward into the wrists. So a really good exercise. Makes you feel like you're using the whole body. And there should be no pressure on the back. So you should be okay with that one. Okay. Let's do a opposite arm to leg stability exercise. So this is really good for keeping the whole body nice and still, for your balance and for control, and really good for the core. So I will go sideways and you're going to extend and lift your opposite arm and leg. So you're going to take them out to the side, or out in front and behind you, not to the side, sorry, and lift and lower. Bring it back in. We're going to do it again. And you're really not going to move the body as you do this. So I don't want you to arch your back. I don't want you to lift your leg too high. Breathe out as you lift. And one more on this side. And lower. So you don't want to take your weight too far back. You don't want to sink into your hips. You've got to pull up and lift the whole time, okay? So let's swap sides. So, making sure that you're nice and level, you're going to slide, lift, down, and close. And slide, lift, down, and close. And slide, lift, down, and close. And slide, lift, down, and close. Last two. And relax. Good. You can go a little bit slower. I think I just speeded up on the last set, so I do apologise. Okay, we're going to stretch our hamstring, which is something that you should be doing every day, or at least every week, or after you've exercised. So a band in your house is an absolute essential item. If you haven't got one, you can use a towel, and it just helps to keep everything nice and in line. So you're going to place the band around the foot as you come back down, and you're going to take the leg up. So the leg can start on the floor. You're going to have a soft knee, and you're never going to bounce the leg, okay? So I'm going to just do nice, four on the side coming forwards, and then swapping sides. Two. If you feel that you need a little block to hold your head, then you can just gently lift and lower. Okay, placing the band down. Pushing up into the shoulder bridge and slowly coming back down. I want you to go nice and slow. I want you to press your spine into the mat, and I want you to gently push as you come up and slowly coming back down. You don't have to use your arms if you find that too hard as you lift. Slowly come back down, or you can just gently bring your arms just to the ceiling and slowly coming back down.
You don't want your arms to go all the way over to the floor because you're going to lose that abdominal connection and the rib flare. And if you flare your ribs, then you're gonna, the tummy isn't going to work, so your abdominals are not going to work as much. So you want to try and keep the ribs down, the arms are only going to come up so high and low. So you can do another set of 8 or 10, whatever you feel, but that's also really nice. Okay, so I'm going to leave you with one last back stretch, which is really lovely. You're going to lie onto your back. You're going to cross your leg over and just gently bring it over to the side and coming back up and swap over, turn your head. The leg's going to go to the other side and bring it up. Let's do that once more. So the legs can be bent. The leg just gently comes over. You're going to turn the other way and swap. And coming up sitting. You take your legs out in front of you. Let's just gently reach up. I want you to do a deep breath in. So breathe in and breathe out. And again, deep breath. And over you go. Coming up, bringing the leg across. Twist and turn the leg to the side. So you're going to twist into the leg and then twist away from the leg. So you're going to feel it in your back. You're also going to feel that stretch in the back of your leg. Swap sides. So turn and twist. Sitting up as tall as you can and change sides and relax. Okay, so your little workout is done. Remember, you can always, I think you can pause. I've said this before, I don't actually know the way you can pause this workout as a live, I don't know. I think if you go back, you can pause me and do another set and then continue on the workout. Remember, I need you to be safe because I am not there doing the workout with you. If you're not sure, you can email me or anyone here at the clinic and we will always be available to answer your questions and your queries. And if you come to class, you can always ask and have make sure that we've seen you, that you're doing it correctly, and then you can go home and carry on. So make sure you're safe, make sure you stay hydrated, and make sure you stay warm because it's cold. All right, so hopefully you've enjoyed that tiny little workout for today, and hopefully I'll see you next Monday, and we will be celebrating our 5th birthday, so I hope you can join us then. All right, so I'll see you all later. Take care.